Closer look at the thing while it's sitting still here. It needs to sit level. See how it's sitting level on the ground? I have seen a ton of YouTube videos where I was kind of looking into these things where people have them pitched forward. And so your rear blade's not doing anything. What we had to do was take the top link off. We had to buy this new top link because the one we had wasn't short enough. You couldn't get it level. So this one made it work. I might have to change this arrangement a little because that pin is a little smaller than that hole. It'd be a little sloppy, but it's working for now. So yeah, we did have to change the top link so we were able to level it. The teeth we haven't really done anything with. Haven't dug in. It's hard and dry now. I think the time to do this would be when things are thawing out at the end of winter, when it's kind of soft, and maybe dig in and fluff up a little more. So we wanted at least 8 foot so it would cover the path of the tractor. So really, if you hug your tires up against something, you're pretty much getting everything you want to get. The teeth could go down one more notch. When it digs in, they touch a little bit, but not too much. But see, we could put them down like another inch and then really dig if you wanted to. So I got this kind of satellite grain bin location done. I'm gonna go over to my house because there's kind of two potholes over there. We back out of the garage and turn, and where we turn, there's kind of two holes in the driveway where doesn't matter how much stone I put in there, they always seem to come back. So I'm gonna see if this thing will tune those up. But that's kind of a tour here of our Frontier LP1208. I guess that's how you say it. 8 for the 8 foot, but I'm pretty happy with the job it's doing. I'm really happy with this edge I put on the grass. Kind of filled it in. It was a low spot. I've only been running this thing for 20, 30 minutes or so. So kind of getting the hang of it, but that looks nice. If we go over here, this is where weeds grow all the time because when we pull the semis in to go to the bins, they don't really go over here. So it doesn't get, you know, worked around, weeds knocked down. So got those ripped out. Maybe more weeds will grow since it's kind of filled up a little bit, but it looks better. We learned quickly it helps to do what I'm doing here and kind of grab a pile that you leave. If you start at the end, of course you gotta start somewhere, it really just scrapes it clean. You've gotta get enough that it's working over both blades and falling over them to get a nice even path. And then you can kind of lift it and level it out. You can kind of learn to feather your hitch and not leave a pile when you're done. But you kind of want to, you know, have a pile here or there to get started so you're not scraping it clean down of the dirt when you begin.